My dear doctor friends, this is Dr. Jatan from Krishnagar. Welcome to the channel Geo Jatan. Geo stands for Gynecology and Obstetrics. Medical science needs continuous update of knowledge and recent advances. We doctors cannot leave our hospital and go for conferences frequently. YouTube has seen tremendous explosion of knowledge in different fields of science and technology, but not in the field of medicine, including obstetrics and gynecology. So, my dear friends, this is my sincere attempt to bridge the gap. Hope you will definitely like it and it will enrich you. So, my dear friends, my name is Dr. Jatan Kumar Rajchoudhury. And today's topic of discussion is drugs and substance abuse in pregnancy. I am highly indebted to the textbook of Obstetrics, Normal and Problem Pregnancies, High Risk Pregnancy Management Options, Williams Obstetrics and SCOG and RCOG journals. Teratogenic effect of specific drugs. Isotretinoin used for cystic acne, and it is preferable to be used with some reversible contraceptive to avoid pregnancy. It is a FDA category X drug. First trimester exposure may cause 25% structural anomalies and another 25% mental retardation. Defects include craniofacial like microtia, small ears, micrognathia, cleft palate, and cardiovascular system like transposition of the great vessels and ventricular septal defect. Unlike vitamin A, it is not stored in the body, so pregnancy is safe after discontinuation of the drug. Vitamin A, the vitamin A level in prenatal vitamins is around 5000 international unit per day and it is safe. So also the dose of beta carotene in the usual prenatal vitamins. Teratogenesis may start with vitamin A dose above 10000 international unit per day, but definitely above 25000 international unit per day. Teratogenesis of psychoactive drugs. Selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors. Contrary to the previous trials, the recent trials does not indicate increased miscarriage, stillbirth or neonatal mortality with first trimester SSRI use. Some studies suggest that SSRIs pose an elevated risk for fetal cardiac defect. Paroxetine is mostly implicated to cause ventricular defects. Sertraline also may slightly increase VSDs. In addition, the risk of persistent pulmonary hypertension rose in some newborn exposed to SSRI after 20 weeks of pregnancy. Two large-scale case control studies revealed no increased risk overall for malformations, including cardiac anomalies with SSRI exposure. Neonates exposed to SSRI may exhibit direct serotonergic effect or withdrawal symptoms similar to opioid withdrawal, but usually mild and resolution by 2 weeks. The symptoms include jitteriness, irritability, and feeding problems. Lithium. A prospective study of 148 women exposed to lithium in the first trimester showed no difference in the incidence of major anomaly except one case of Epstein anomaly. The author concluded that lithium is not a major teratogen. However, these pregnant mothers should be offered anatomy study and fetal echocardiography. Polyhydramnios may be a sign of fetal lithium toxicity. Lithium may be withheld 24 to 48 hours before delivery to reduce neonatal complications. Benzodiazepines. A fetal benzodiazepine syndrome has been described, and earlier studies showed increased cleft lip and palate with these CNS depressants. However, recent studies indicate that the teratogenic risk of benzodiazepine exposure, if any, is very small. When taken in the third trimester, it may cause neonatal withdrawal seizures or hypotonia. Teratogenesis of anticoagulant drugs. Warfarin. Warfarin is a pregnancy category X drug. It can cause nasal and mid-face hypoplasia, microphthalmia, mental retardation between 6 to 12 weeks of gestation. In addition, warfarin may cause fetal hemorrhage and so rarely used in pregnancy. Except in some patients, we can use it with artificial heart valves. Unfractionated heparin and low molecular weight heparin are the better alternatives in pregnancy. Teratogenesis of antithyroid drugs. The two widely used antithyroid drugs are propyl thiouracil and methimazole. Both drugs cross placenta and they may cause neonatal goiter. The maternal thyroid hormones counteract this effect, but they cross poorly and so they are always kept in a slightly hyperthyroid state. Liver toxicity with propyl thiouracil and embryopathy with methimazole are special concern. Aplasia cutis congenita, that means absence of skin and punched out ulcer on the parietal region of the scalp, may occur with methimazole. Specific embryopathy called methimazole embryopathy in the form of choanal atresia, tracheoesophageal fistula, esophageal atresia, omphalocele, athelia, they may develop in methimazole therapy in the first trimester. Overall major anomalies with methimazole, mostly the methimazole embryopathy variety, is around 4%, which is twice the normal range of 2%. And this high risk is confined between 6 to 10 weeks, that means the period of organogenesis. Propyl thiouracil induced abnormality is comparatively less. Radioactive iodine used either for thyroid ablation or diagnosis is contraindicated in pregnancy as it crosses placenta and may cause severe irreversible fetal hypothyroidism. But as it is not concentrated by fetal thyroid until 12 weeks of pregnancy, so with inadvertent use in first trimester, probably there is no specific risk to the fetal thyroid gland results. Teratogenesis of antihypertensive drugs. ACE inhibitors and ARBs in the first trimester does not increase birth defects. Second and third trimester exposure causes potential adverse fetal effects like fetal renal tubular dysplasia leading to oligohydramnios, fetal limb contracture, hypoplastic lung and renal failure. So it is avoided in pregnancy. Atenolol during first and second trimester reduces growth of the fetus and placenta. No such effect with other beta blockers such as metoprolol, pindolol, but data on their use in pregnancy is limited. Both alpha beta blocker labetalol, calcium channel blocker like nifedipine, methyl dopa and hydralazine are comparatively safe in pregnancy. Thiazide diuretics are better avoided in pregnancy as they may increase the risk of congenital malformation and they may interfere with physiological hypervolemia of pregnancy. However, other studies show that it does not cause any significant adverse fetal and neonatal events, but it is better to discontinue if superimposed preeclampsia or superimposed IUGR, as it may reduce the utero-placental blood flow by secondary reduction of plasma volume. Teratogenesis of antimicrobial drugs. Penicillin, ampicillin and amoxicillin are safe in pregnancy. Clavulanate added to amoxicillin broadens the antibacterial spectrum and is safe in first trimester. It is, however, avoided as a potential therapy for chorioamnionitis in a case of PPROM, as it disturbs the microbial flora of GI tract and favors necrotizing enterocolitis. Erythromycin is a better drug, and no teratogenic risk of erythromycin has also been reported in first trimester use. No significant birth defect observed with azithromycin and clarithromycin also. Cephalosporins are comparatively safe in first trimester and also later on. Sulfonamides, when combined with trimethoprim, is used to treat infections in pregnancy. Recent studies in first trimester did not found increased risk, and ACOG considers sulfonamides appropriate for first trimester use if suitable alternatives are lacking. But as they displace bilirubin from the protein binding site, so theoretically they may potentiate neonatal hyperbilirubinemia if used before preterm delivery. Aminoglycosides. Some preterm neonates treated with gentamicin or streptomycin have developed nephrotoxicity and ototoxicity. However, no adverse effects or congenital defects noted resulting from their prenatal exposure. Nitrofurantoin, used in the treatment of acute uncomplicated UTI as well as for long-term suppression in chronic bacteriuria. No reports have associated NFT with congenital defects. It may induce hemolytic anemia in patients with G6PD deficiency. Three recent case control studies have found slight increased risk of hypoplastic left heart. So ACOG has concluded that first trimester NFT use is appropriate if no suitable alternatives are available. Fluoroquinolones, they have a high affinity for bone tissue and cartilage. However, no malformation or musculoskeletal problems noted in the neonates who are exposed to the drug in the first trimester. Metronidazole, it is safe in first trimester as well as later gestation. Thank you for your patient watching. If you like the video, please subscribe. Namaste.